The rest of basketball season was quite exciting as well.
It was a great year for all Ball State sports. Here's a quick look at some of the highlights. So many highlights in so little time. All the Ball State athletes had a great year, and that is something to be proud of.
And next year we'll have room for even more fans for basketball, volleyball, and other sports. Construction crews have been busy on the new arena this past year, and work is pretty much on schedule, with the 12,000-seat facility expected to be ready at the end of 1991.
It has been 23 years since there has been any expansion of the physical education facilities at Ball State. And what better a way to change that than to build the largest indoor forum on campus? The same architects that designed the Hoosier Dome and the Sports Center Tennis Stadium in Indianapolis are in charge of this project. It will contain classrooms, laboratories, and specialized fitness areas such as an indoor jogging track and a weight room.
Phase one of the health and physical activity complex was completed in the spring. It's occupied by the Institute for Wellness, the Human Performance Laboratory, the School of Physical Education, and Men's and Women's Intercollegiate Athletics.
Renovations also took place across campus. The administration building facelift is now in phase two as work continues on Ball State's oldest building. Just about everywhere you looked, there were improvement projects underway.
All of the work is part of the campus master plan, and will keep Ball State looking good as it nears its 75th anniversary celebration in 1993.
There's more than one way to spruce up a college campus. Ball State is planning for the future with plant life as well.
Ball State will double the number of trees and shrubs on campus by the year 2000. The university's forestation plan is intended to increase the number of species on campus and make the campus more attractive. New trees will help reduce pollution by absorbing exhaust fumes and reduce energy costs by shading buildings in the summer. They will also create homes for birds and other small wildlife.
Imagine this area where students now scurry through this not well-planned space. Imagine a tree-lined canopy down through this nice boulevard, and just think of how people would react in a very positive way to such a positive environment.
Forestation committee members plan to increase the number of plant species on campus to provide a living laboratory for students. There are now 425 species on campus, up from 350 in 1990. The goal is to have 750 species by the year 2000.
Environmental awareness has sure grown recently.
Of course, Ball State students try to be aware of current events as well. The 1990-91 school year brought war to the Middle East, and everyone's routine changed.
On Wednesday, January 16th at 4:50 p.m., President George Bush declared, "The liberation of Kuwait has begun." The attack on Iraq was in retaliation to Saddam Hussein's invasion of oil-rich Kuwait. Even though the action was taking place a half a world away, Ball State students kept up on the events. Just about every TV was tuned to CNN, and the viewers watched intently. New terminology became household words, such as sorties, scud, and chemical warheads. Some students got involved by showing their opposition to the fighting in the Gulf, marching in several demonstrations, and camping in peace tents on the quad. At the same time, hundreds turned out to show their support for the American troops involved in the conflict. They marched, sang, and carried signs in favor of the soldiers in the Gulf. After the war had ended, students went back to their normal routines, with the memories of the war still fresh in their minds.
If next year is as busy as this one was, it could only be positive for Ball State.
We only scratched the surface of 1990-91, but we hope we've given you a sense of how the university has grown and prospered. And by looking back, you can see that the foundations are in place for another year in the life of a premier teaching university. For Ball State University, I'm Amy Bowman.
And I'm Paul Nicely. Thanks for watching. So long.